The Cosmic Desktop Alpha is coming along strong. Yes, it's still very much a work in progress, and yes, it's not exactly ready for me to daily drive right now. I'm still using KDE, and that's going to be the case for quite a while longer, because every time I go back to it for a new version stream, there are new issues I discover. There are new major blockers I find. Some of them are new to the code base. Some of them are just newly discovered, but it's still something that's not ready for me to personally daily drive. It's ready for the developers to dog food, but I want to wait just a little bit longer. The desktop is improving very rapidly though, and that's thanks to this really long alpha cycle where they're just committing new things, fixing bugs as they happen, and actually having people test it out before they want to make a full release and ship it out to everybody. After that, there's going to be a still long, but relatively much shorter beta cycle, and by that point, hopefully most of the things are like ironed out. If not perfect, because no software is perfect, good enough for most people. And it's getting very close to that. And if you ask me, I don't think there is a better way they could have approached this. If they just designed it behind closed doors the entire time and then got to the point where they're ready for release and is like, hey guys, here's Cosmic. Yes, a lot of things are going to be ironed out, but every time you have users that are not your developers with hardware configurations that are not your own, you're gonna find things you didn't realize, especially when users try to do things you didn't expect them to do. Always assume your users are malicious and are going to try to break something, because if most of them aren't, I'm going to. But right now, outside of the PopOS 24.04 LTS Alpha, which is still available here, and they're updating it as they have new versions, there's not really anything shipping Cosmic. Yes, there are packages on a lot of distros, but you don't have a distro where it's like, Cosmic is our core desktop. Cosmic is one of the options we have available. It's a flavor, it's a spin, whatever term you want to use. And this should be expected. It's an alpha, it's not ready, it is getting changes very frequently, and you wouldn't exactly want to have users on one version of Cosmic for 3 or 6 months, because by that point, there are going to be a lot of things that change. It is going to be in a considerably better state. But it was obviously going to happen eventually, and Fedora now has a Cosmic spin proposal. And this should be expected. It's an alpha, it's not ready, and it's not having the kind of regression testing that a full release is going to have. You might have one commit where it seems like it works, it compiles, it looks like it does the thing, but it turns out it introduced a regression and nobody knew, so users then suddenly have some major feature broken. This is just the way that alpha development is done, and the only way to get around that is lock users on one version for like 3 or so months, and with it being an alpha and with things changing so quickly and new things being added, that's just not really great for the user. But it was obviously going to happen eventually, and now there is an official Fedora Cosmic spin proposal over in Fedora. As I say every time I talk about a Fedora proposal, this is just a proposal for a change. It is not guaranteed to happen. It might not happen when it says it happens. It might not ever happen. This is just a thing that developers want to do. Now, as for the people involved, one of them you know very well if you watch this channel, that being Neil Gomper. Now, Neil does many things. In Fedora, he's involved in KDE. He's involved in Asahi. I'm sure there are other things. He's involved in the OpenSUSE project. A million different things. Now, a name you may not have heard before is Ryan Brew. This is the person directly related to Cosmic. He is the maintainer of the uBlue Cosmic Atomic image. So if you want to use Cosmic in an atomic way, this is probably what you're going to go with. He is also the maintainer of the Cosmic Epoch package over on the Fedora Copper. This is basically Fedora's equivalent of the AUR. And he's also been involved in doing this stuff since basically the very start. So this post right here was made on March 2nd, long before the alphas actually started. And Ryan is already being referenced in this initial packaging effort, in this initial interest in a cosmic spin, in something Fedora and cosmic. As with most things in the Fedora project, things exist because there is a community of contributors who come together to make it happen. We manifest things into existence. Fedora Cosmic and Ryan's work can go far, but only if he's supported by more people. If you want to see Fedora Cosmic happen, pitching in is the best way to make it happen. Below are priority items that Ryan put together for those looking to get involved. If you have questions or would like to dive into contribution, please join us in the Matrix Room for Fedora Cosmic. At the time, there were a bunch of things to be done. Now let's go back over to the proposal. The Cosmic Desktop Environment is a new Rust-based desktop environment developed by System76, makers of PopOS, which I don't... Is that the correct styling for PopOS? I don't know why they style the name like this. I don't think anyone writes it correctly anyway. The desktop environment is set to reach maturity in the first quarter of 2025. Cosmic has many unique features, such as hybrid per workspace Windows / tiling management, window stacks with tabs to switch between windows, and robust customization features that integrate with GTK and later on Qt. Hopefully, maybe Qt. There are people they're talking to make this happen. It's just Qt and KDE is bit more complex of a stack when it comes to customization. Now, this window is based on things that Carl Rochelle, the CEO of System76, has said on my show, has said in various other places, like this Ubuntu talk that happened very recently, so I'll let him just say it for himself.
It's been a 3-year journey. We are getting close. We believe that there will be a beta release in January or February. As many of you know, when you have a beta release, it attracts a lot more users. I'm sure we're going to learn a lot at that point. Depending on how much we learn and how many things we've missed during the alpha releases, I would expect first release in February or March of next year. There will inevitably be things that we wanted to get in the first release that we didn't. So we plan to have a second release next year as well. We'll fill in some of those gaps.
As someone who's done quite a bit of testing on stream, I very much have doubts about this window. This would mean the first beta release is the next release, and the state that Cosmic was in when I last used it does not give me hope the next release is going to be beta. Maybe the release after that I could see. As for it being March or February for like the first full release of the project, absolutely zero chance. They are not doing a single beta and then going into release. They're going to do the beta. A lot more people are going to try it. Tons of bugs are going to be discovered, and they'll need at least one more beta after that. This is really, really hopeful. I do think they'll have a second release in 2025, but the first, that's not going to happen. Probably at least April or May. That would be my more realistic guess. Fedora is already one of the most popular distro choices for Cosmic, being the first result past PopOS on the official Cosmic website of where to try it out. So that's right here. Under that is NixOS and then Arch Linux. Obviously, you can't really say it's the most popular based on that. That's not exactly like how that like measurement works. But I would be surprised if it's not a popular option. I would be very surprised if NixOS is a more popular option than Arch Linux, though. Redox, that makes sense to be down here. You know, it's Redox. I like Jeremy, but like, Redox is... It's Redox. Having an official spin for Cosmic is a logical next step to bring these users to a more streamlined experience, for example, making use of ISO generations for spins. Cosmic is also shaping up to be a great quality desktop experience. It's shaping up to be that. It's not there just yet. It's mostly there, but there's a couple of like edge cases where things are a bit weird. Now, as can be seen from the post way back in March, which is long before the alphas actually started, this idea of making a Fedora Cosmic spin, is not a new idea, and was obviously going to eventually happen. And you may recall a video I did earlier in the year about exactly this. And this post here is not the earliest post on the idea. That goes back even further to January 22nd. Cosmic Desktop Environment on Fedora. The Rust-based Cosmic Desktop Environment for System76 is approaching an alpha release. It will be a while before it's stable and ready. Definitely a while. It was less stable and ready at that point, but it's still gonna take a while from there. According to one of the devs, they do not have plans to create RPM packages or a copper repository for Cosmic, but they expect the communities of various distros to do so if they want it. They were willing to, like, help people out with things and make sure there are, like, bugs that are addressed and things like that, but they didn't want to be the ones doing the downstream packaging for every single distro. They don't want to maintain all of the packages on Arch, on Fedora, on Ubuntu, and everything else that wants it. If a distro community wants it enough, somebody is going to do so. And that's totally reasonable. This is the way that most applications are handled. This is the way that GNOME and KDE work as well. And they already have packages they maintain themselves, that being on Popwest. So maintaining that on other things, that's just a lot of additional work that they didn't want to get themselves into. Now, at the time, Draculix, otherwise known as Victoria Breckenfield, did have a custom Silverblue image that allowed you to go and use Cosmic. This is the developer behind Smithy, the library being used on the Cosmic desktop. Also, she's very heavily involved in the development of Cosmic as well. Now, from this, we see the first mention of Ryan Brew wanting to get involved, parroting the interest shown above. I'd like to help create a Cosmic SIG, a special interest group, basically a group that is focused around doing a thing on Fedora. There's a KDE SIG, there's a GNOME SIG, there's one for Asahi, and a bunch of other projects within Fedora. It's basically like little groups to maintain little projects. That's effectively it. When Cosmic moves closer to release. Being someone who currently uses Silverblue / OSTree based desktops, I've updated Draculix's image to the latest Cosmic and created several images based on user needs. That takes us to the UBlue image that I showed you earlier. Now, whilst he said he wanted to do it closer to release, February 16th, literally the same day, he went and made a proposal about making a Cosmic SIG. And if you ever think you can't get involved with a project because you just don't have experience working with it, this is my first time using a mailing list. Ryan was first getting involved with the project, with doing this. If there is something you want to do, if there is something you want to learn, you can absolutely go ahead and do so. And would you look at that? The first comment under this thread. Neil Gumper. This sounds great. I just realized Ryan was using a Hotmail address at the time. Jesus Christ. I didn't know there were people that still actively used Hotmail. Now, whilst it wasn't the case at the time, as it stands today, basically everything is in place to make a Fedora Cosmic spin. Everything is packaged, or at least packaged in copper, and can be moved over whenever it needs to be done. So the real question then becomes, when does this actually happen? This was asked over in the discussion thread. Do we ship an official Fedora spin with Cosmic while Cosmic is still in alpha, or are we going to wait until it reaches beta / RC status? The hope is that Cosmic will be stable before the Fedora 42 release. If not, I'd still like to pursue the Cosmic spin. It makes sense to get the ball rolling, in my opinion. So, Fedora 42 releases in April of next year. So that would mean you would want something to be ready probably sometime during March, if not earlier. Maybe you'll be able to package a beta then, but I just don't believe this schedule until it actually happens. This seems way too good to be true. This seems very, very optimistic and doesn't leave much room for additional releases being required. I don't think this is going to actually happen in the release thinks it's going to happen in. With that being said, it doesn't mean it just goes to waste. The contingency plan is pushing it back until Fedora 43. So that'll be October of that year. And there is absolutely no chance that it's not going to be ready by then. maybe not second release, but absolutely first release will be done by then. And sadly, this is how it has to be done, because Fedora isn't really set up to do off-cycle official releases, so if you wanted it to be an official spin, they kind of have to, you know, get everything ready to align with the schedule. And that just makes sense, right? You don't really want to have random spins, especially new ones, just doing some other random thing unrelated to the main schedule, because it throws everything out. And then other people start asking, well, why can't I do things off cycle? And why can't I do things off cycle? And then you just don't have a cycle anymore. I know there are people out there that want me to go and use Fedora. Hey, why don't you use Fedora KDE? Why don't you use Fedora Cosmic when it's ready? But you know what? I'm gonna keep using Arch, because for me, Arch is fine. I have my system set up. Everything is good. I don't need to think about it. People say Arch breaks a lot. It doesn't. Just don't break things and it won't break. So this is cool, but it's not the thing I'm going to be running. But it does make it a lot easier for people that do exist in Fedora land to go and make use of Cosmic. Also, it's going to be ready soon, and more people need to be testing it to make sure it's actually in a good state and is actually ready to go and ship to the wider users and is ready for the new release eventually of PopOS when that one day happens. I am excited for Cosmic. I'm going to keep testing it out. I'm going to keep trying making better, and hopefully it gets to a point where I actually feel comfortable daily driving it on my system, and at the rate we're going, that will be pretty soon. But what do you think? Have you tried out Cosmic? Are you using it right now? Do you think the Cosmic is dumb? Do you hate Rust? Do you just hate Rust in its entirety and everything written in Rust? I'd love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to Liberapay, link in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and can your blood rust? Because there's like iron in it. I actually don't know.